say, your position is that no person who is demonically possessed could be guilty of murder.
Absolutely. The person has no free will. He loses the intent which the murder charge requires. It's impossible for an individual to manifest the specific intent when he's demonically possessed.
Prior to this, had you believed any of that?
Well, I've always been a Catholic and believed in God, but since I've been involved in this, I am a firm believer. Uh-huh. And a national Gallup poll conducted 15 months ago for the magazine Christianity Today has shown that 34% of the adult population believe that the devil is a personal being who directs evil forces and who influences people to do wrong.
Hey, John!
One more question.
No, I'm sorry, John. I'm due inside.
How about the 11-year-old? Will he be part of this trial?
Yes, he, I think, will be a very important part of this trial.
Are you going to have to prove he is possessed before you prove Mr. Miller is?
First, we have to prove the existence of possession to a jury, and then that Mr. Miller is, in fact, demonically possessed.
Are you saying that Mr. Miller is still possessed?
The demon has not left Mr. Miller's body.
Hey, John, why don't you hold him?
Why, Mr. Clarion, you'll have to learn to hold your own around here.
Hey, well, who was it? Who's the guy?
Anthony Marino, defense attorney.
Joan, I'd like to open it with him.
Well, he has an opening of his own, like a murder trial.
You want a cup of coffee?
Okay, make it fast.
Now, wait a minute. Are you trying to tell me that this defense of demonic possession is based on a whole set of sequences which nobody except the immediate family has witnessed?
Just what it's been, a family affair. Except for the demonologist and his wife, the psychic.
Guy is Charlotte Harris.
Exactly right. Except for them and the priest involved, nobody else.
Not even the cops?
Just around the edges.
Huh. Well, how have you been able to report it? Why does anybody believe it?
The world is divided into believers and non-believers. And most people start out and remain one or the other, no matter what the evidence.
All right. And just from what you know, what do you think?
I think it's going to be a hell of an interesting day in court.
Your Honor, I am prepared to introduce the testimony of 5 priests, 2 lay experts in demonology, and the bishop himself.
To establish that demonic possession exists, Mr. Marino, the court will take judicial notice that the art, science, profession, religious science, business, hobby, whatever it's called, on locating demons and determining what effect they have on human actions at any given moment has not risen to the level of reliability wherein evidence from that field could be of valid assistance to a jury in discovering the truth, but rather would even confuse or mislead it. Any evidence in that field would be incompetent evidence. I will not allow it.
Your Honor, may we have a recess?
Sure.
All right. Court is now in recess.
Mr. Marino, what did you think of Judge Hughes' statement?
I was flabbergasted by the ruling. If Hughes has prejudged this case before any evidence is submitted, he should disqualify himself.
But you had to know that your defense was subject to dispute. You said it would be a first, an historic first.
And it will be. This entire defense will be seen by the world through the eyes of the media. Excuse me.
Mr. Harris.
I tell you, this is a battleground. This is not a case of murder. This is a confrontation between the devil and the human race.
I thought you said your new house was going to need a real good cleaning.
We hardly got started. What happened?
Well, there was this big waterbed the former tenants left behind.
King size.
Well, we're all playing on it, you know, bouncing up and down. But then Brian went in alone. And from what he says, something grabbed him, threw him on the bed, and bounced him up and down.
Something grabbed him? What do you mean, something?
I saw the floor.
It is not, Terry. I saw it.
Saw him grab him?
No. I saw Brian bouncing on the bed. Brian saw this thing.
What thing?
He
says it's a little man about 4 feet high.
All burned black with a torn plaid shirt.
And feet like a deer.
He calls us a beast.
Oh, come on. Oh,
Brian, if he really thinks he saw that thing, he must be scared to death. Where is he?
He's down by the road. He says the beast followed us home.
He kept seeing it?
All along the highway.
Good Lord.
Now, Connie, all kids see things. He'll get over it.
Did you really see this little man?
The beast, Mom. I saw him.
What'd he look like?
Like he'd been burnt all over in a fire. All black and charred. And his eyes way back in.
Anything else?
Yeah. He had an old beat-up hat and a plaid shirt. And jeans with holes in the knees. And he had little feet with hooves on them like a deer.
Did he say anything?
Yeah. He said, beware. And he pointed his finger at me, and then he threw me up and down.
What's his name, did he say?
The Beast. That's his name.
It's all over now. You never have to go back there again.
I'm not going back. But neither is he.
Neither is he? Do you mean the Beast?
Yeah. He followed us all the way here from Newtown.
Do you mean that he's here now?
Yeah, he was down there by the gate when we came in.
Brian, are you sure?
You think I'm crazy, don't you?
No.
Or maybe I'm making it up.
Brian, I believe every word that you're saying.
I hope so, Mom. Because I'm really scared.
Sometimes there's a medical explanation.
Look, Nancy, I know Brian. He's my friend. He's almost my little brother. He just doesn't see things that aren't there.
Ken, I appreciate your loyalty to Brian, but what do you say? You believe in little men?
Well, I believe in God. And I believe there are things called devils or, you know, demons. What?
I'm not going to move into that house.
What? What, are you kidding? You'll lose your deposit.
I don't care. I'm not going back there.
Yeah, well, where are we going to live then?
I don't know. We'll have to stay here.
Nancy. Look, I love you. I love you forever, but, you know, we're really not welcome here until we get married.
Well, my family will have to learn how to deal with it. And we'll find another place as soon as we can.
And then we'll get married. What do you mean, we'll see?
I mean, don't rush things.
Rush things? We've been going together for years.
Yeah. And you're still only 19. And I'm older than you are. I just wanted to be sure.
I'm sure.
Just be satisfied with what you got.
It ain't what I got, it's what I want to get.
About Brian.
Honey, I have to be up at 5.
I know, but he really thinks that he saw this beast, as he calls it.
Kids see things. Not a damn thing you can do about it.
I wouldn't have brought it up if I didn't think it was serious.
Okay. It's serious. Now, what the hell am I supposed to do about it at this hour?
You could act concerned.
I am concerned, but I am also concerned about the county road machinery, which at 5 o'clock tomorrow
morning...
Sorry,
I brought it up.
Just that sometimes I think you care too much.
What does that mean?
Well, you get too involved. You worry a thing to death. When a lot of times, as you said earlier, it
Just ignore something. It'll go away.
I'm not so sure.
Well, it sure isn't going to go away if you keep making such a big deal out of it. Kids do things like this to get attention. And Brian plays you like an accordion. If he told you that he saw the governor of Rhode Island sitting on top of a flagpole spitting marbles, you'd want to know how far.
That's an exaggeration, and you know it.
Not by much.
Look, Sammy!
Oh, my God.
What is it?
Brian says it's the beast again.
He's right over there. Can't you see him? He's got a knife, and he's gonna cut me.
Nobody there. You're having a bad dream.
I'm not asleep, Mom. Watch out, or he'll cut you too.
It's all right, sweetheart. Let me hold you. Oh! Brian, that hurt.
Now that's enough, Brian.
I'm sorry, Mom. I didn't mean it.
It's all right, sweetheart. I know you're upset. Come here. Brian, stop that.
Evening, Mr. Page. You got to complain about the noise.
You got to complain about the noise?
Welcome to the club.
What's going on?
That's a very good question. Why don't you listen a while, then maybe you can tell me.
Honey, there's a cop downstairs complaining about the noise.
No!
You look deep. Hey, something wrong?
Chief, you're not going to believe this. I think I may have just heard the voice of the devil.
What are you making?
Just a milkshake, Mom.
I need my cooking chocolate alone.
Dinner.
Chicken salad and coleslaw. I can make steak for you if you want.
No, it's okay. I had a big lunch. Where's Brian?
It's in his room.
Listen, I don't know what you guys think, but I'm thinking we gotta get some help for Brian. I mean, you know, I love him like a brother, but this staying up half the night, every night, it's wearing me down.
What do you mean help?
Well, you got a medical problem, you call a doctor, but I don't think that Brian's problem is medical. I think we ought to call a priest.
So do I. I think we should call those people. What are their names? The demonologist? The Harrises? I think we should call them first. Why? Because they're the experts.
That's that witch from Bethel. Tell her we're not interested.
Yes, dear.
Hello? Yes, this is Charlotte Harris. Yes, Mrs. Fraser? I see. And how old is Brian? Mrs. Fraser, has the boy seen a doctor? Well, it may not be a medical problem, but until... Yes, of course we'll come. Tonight, in about an hour. And Mrs. Fraser, I hope you'll understand we'll be bringing a doctor with us. Yes, I have it, and the telephone number. We'll be there in about an hour. It's an 11-year-old boy. She thinks he's possessed.
Did she call the priest?
No. But she says she's going to call Father Egan. Have him meet us there.
Oh, good. We better bring the kit.
I think we're out of holy water.
No, we're not. And it'd be nice if for once we didn't need it. If for once all the kid needed was a good, strong laxative.
That reminds me, I have to call the doctor.
Wouldn't that be nice?
Yes, dear.
Death.
Must be the priest man called. The Harrises.
The demonologist?
Yeah. My husband's sleeping. He had a hard day.
Well, I understand that, Mrs. Fraser, but considering what's at stake, I think he ought to be here.
I wouldn't want to wake him up. That must be Father Egan.
Good evening, Mrs. Fraser.
Good evening, Father.
Good evening, Father.
Thank you so much for coming. Please come in.
Is this the boy?
Yeah, this is my son, Brian.
Brian? Mr. Harris.
Father.
Mrs. Harris.
Father.
I've heard of your work, of course.
Thank you, Father. We've heard of you.
Look forward to meeting you.
I wish it might have been under other circumstances.
Of course, Father.
Has the boy had a medical examination, Doctor?
Not yet, Father. We were just getting started.
Well, I think that certainly should be the first order of business.
I don't want to be examined.
What's this? My dear child, what you want is irrelevant. Just as what I want is irrelevant. I want to be home in bed just now, but thanks to you, I am not. Now, you will go with the doctor, and you will be examined, and we'll have no more nonsense about it.
Come on, Brian. If I hurt you, you can kick me in the shins.
thinks he's kidding, if he kicks him in the shins, he'll break his leg.
Pretty strong, is he?
Well, when the beast has him, you wouldn't believe it.
I believe it.
Now, just a minute. Let's hold it right there, Mr. Harris. With all due respect, I would like to say a few preliminary things.
Go right ahead, Father.
First of all, we're not sure what we're dealing with here. It may be a medical problem, Tourette's syndrome, psychological disturbances, who knows?
I couldn't agree more.
I don't agree. Brian is not sick. He's possessed.
Mrs. Frazier, real cases of demonic possession are extremely rare.
I'm his mother. If Brian says that he's seen a demon, he's seen a demon, that's all.
I haven't run any tests, obviously, but he seems physically healthy to me. Look, this isn't my field, but I think there are perfectly plausible psychiatric explanations of what's happening to Brian.
Thank you, Doctor.
Father, why are you so ready to call this a medical problem?
Because, my dear Mrs. Frazier, these are almost invariably medical problems. Mr. Harris, if we may discuss this outside. It's time I was getting back.
Certainly, Father.
That was the beast.
What was that?
Typical three knocks, mocking the Holy Trinity. Miss Frazier, I brought you some things. A relic of St. John Bosco. Some holy water.
I think that's quite enough.
If it starts again, address it in the name of Jesus Christ. Tell it to go away. Here's the holy water. The crucifix. Tell it to depart.
Mr. Harris, I'd like to speak with you.
Yes, Father.
Tell Brian to pray to his guardian angel.
I will, but please tell me. Do you sense evil in this house?
Well, not really.
Mrs. Harris. Mrs. Frazier, I'll be in touch.
My God, Kenny, is this really happening?
Hard to believe.
I'm afraid for Brian.
You know what? I'm afraid for all of us.
Mr. and Mrs. Harris, if I may say so, you surprise me.
How's that, Father?
Well, I've heard of you, of your work as, what's the expression, demonologist?
I'm called a demonologist. Charlotte's a psychic.
Whatever.
What surprises you, Father?
That you would lead these people to believe that the boy is possessed.
Pardon me, Father. We did no such thing.
Well, you speak to them of demonic thumps in the floor, of relics, of guardian angels. What else are they to think?
Tell me, Father, do you believe in the demonic?
Of course I do. But in this case...
In any case, Father, it's better to be safe than sorry. All we did was arm this family against the devil in a very small way. If the devil isn't here, then no harm's been done.
But there is harm done. You lead them to believe that they're making sense.
Good night, Father.
Joan.
Oh, good evening, stranger. What are you doing here? You must finally have made an arrest.
Well, I participated.
I hear you participated in a seance or something.
The chief must have told you.
Yeah.
Well, it wasn't a seance, but it was something. I tell you, Joan, I've never been so scared in my life.
Well, what was it? What'd you see?
I didn't see anything. It was what I heard. You would have swore the devil himself was in the next room.
Oh, come on, the devil.
It's easy for you to laugh, but I heard it.
Well, I was just trying to find out what it was.
It's none of this world, Joan, that's all I can tell you.
Well, it could have been a recording.
Sure,
I mean, you didn't see what it was making the sound.
No, I didn't. Where in hell would they make a recording like that? Except in hell.
O clement, O loving, O sweet Virgin Mary, pray for us, O Holy Mother of God.
That we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ.
Amen. Guy, what do you really think?
I'll be amazed if it isn't demonic. 40 miles of real bad road.
We don't have to take it.
You know somebody else?
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Sorry to get you up, Gary.
Are you kidding? Who can sleep with all this going on?
Brian, don't you know who I am? Don't you know I love you?
Get out!
Don't you know Jesus loves you?
He will burn him out!
Say you love Jesus,
say
Brian.
Say it, Brian.
You love
say
Jesus.
It. It won't work. He won't say it. He won't say anything.
Don't put the crucifix on his forehead.
No! No! Kill you!
You won't kill anybody.
Get out of my sight! You get out of Brian!
You think he's so strong? I'm stronger than you are!
I'll kill you all!
You won't kill anybody! You're not strong enough! You can't even beat me!
You will die!
You think it's so tough? Huh? You come out of Brian! Come into me! Come on, leave Brian! Come into me!
Kenny, what are you saying?
No, no, no!
Don't ever say that. Listen to me, Kenny. Don't you ever challenge the demon. He was here before man was created. He was here before the world was created. He looks upon God himself as his only proper enemy. Don't you ever invite the demon to take you on, because I guarantee you he will. I don't know what else to tell you, Father. I just spent half the night with the Frazier boy, and if he isn't possessed by an inhuman spirit, I've never seen him.
Perhaps you never have.
Is that your final word, Father?
No. No, of course not. I beg your pardon. You are pretty insistent about this.
I think we should go to the bishop.
We? I'm not going anywhere near the bishop.
The point is, there is an 11-year-old boy who is being hammered by something. We have the obligation to do the best that we can.
Mr. Harris, if I may interrupt, has it ever occurred to you that what the little boy is being hammered by is some sort of psychological aberration?
Of course it has. We aren't quacks or imbeciles. We read the medical literature.
Then you take it to the bishop. I want nothing more to do with it. I mean, I will, of course, insist. The bishop approves an exorcism. And if I agree with the conclusions of the investigation, there will be an investigation.
We know.
A very thorough investigation, if I know the bishop and his investigator, Father Dietrich.
Once and for all, the fallen and apostate tyrant into the flames of hell. Holy Lord, Almighty Father, hasten to our call for help, and snatch from ruination and the clutches of the noonday devil this human being, made in your image and likeness,
Strike terror, Lord, in the beast now laying waste your vineyard. I command you, unclean spirit, whoever you are with all your minions, that you, by some sign, tell me your name. I cast you out, unclean spirit, along with every satanic power of the enemy, with every specter from hell, with all of your fellow companions. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, be gone and stay forever away from this creature of God, for it is he who commands you.
Joan Greenway.
Hi, cop shop.
You'll talk to who?
At the Fraser house.
Who?
And Father Dietrich
is investigating.
Oh.
Exorcism? Here? In Newport?
Hidden. I exorcise you, unclean spirit, in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Ghost. For it is he who repels, he who expels you, he who has prepared everlasting fire for you and your angels, he who is to come to judge the living and the dead in the world by fire. Amen.
We need some help here. Charlotte. Father and the Son and the Holy Ghost.
I command you, unclean spirit, whoever you are with all your minions, now attacking this servant of God, that you tell me by some sign your name. Your name?
My name is Legion. Legion.
Your particular name? I command you, tell me who you are.
I am Renzo Novus Flagus, Dementia Evil, from us deliver, but temptation into not us lead.
Stop!
I am Reasonable Novus.
Father, wait.
What do you want to know?
Name. Your name!
My name. My name. I am Racer Celibus. He is Racer Celibus. A demon of lust.
Morning, Richard.
Morning, Joan. You've been there all night?
No, I always sleep here.
Hey, is what they tell me is going on, is it really going on over there?
Come on, Richard, I'm the competition.
Can I get in there with the crew?
I don't know. Have to ask the devil.
For all I'm getting out of you, I might as well. Do you think they believe that? Devils creeping around, possessing people. Seriously, do you think they really believe it?
Oh, well, I spent all night working at it.
Well, now, what do you think? Do you think there's a possibility they're right?
No.
I mean, what if you saw a demon prancing around on that lawn over there? What would you do?
I would saddle up my unicorn and head south.
Who else?
I am Zai. Zai. Zai.
I cannot discern.
How many of you are there? How many? In the name of Jesus Christ, I command you!
Yes, I am. And yes, I you. And yes, I God. We are 42. 42.
They have only named none. Ask them who else, Father.
Who else are you?
We are still Legion. We are many. We are all souls.
No, no.
That's enough.
No, Father, let her continue.
No, no.
Ask them who else, Father.
We are many. We are 42. 42.
Thank you.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry I caused so much trouble.
Oh, Brian. All right. You try to get some sleep, Brian. I'm going to leave you with Father for a while.
Come on, Brian. Let's say a prayer together. Angel of God, my guardian dear, to whom his love commits me here, ever this night be at my side, to light, to guard, to rule, to guide. Amen. Feeling better now?
Yes, Father.
I know it's hard, Brian, with what you're going through, but you mustn't lose faith. God loves you.
Why does God let the beast come at me?
Some of us have to suffer more than others, Brian. Why is a mystery? Why so often it's the little children. That's the biggest mystery of all.
Don't cry, Father. I'll be okay.
Good boy. Now I'm going to give you my blessing. Dear God, look down upon your child, Brian Fraser, and give him peace. In the name of the Father. And of the Son.
Father, excuse me. I'm a reporter. I'm wondering if you could answer a few questions. Oh, Mr. Harris.
Not now, please.
I'm Joan Greenway. I'm a reporter. I want to know what this is all about.
All right.
There's a little boy in there who's possessed. We're trying to drive the demons out of him. It's as simple as
that. Has he seen a psychiatrist?
Mrs. Greenway.
To explain the speculation about schizophrenia and hysteria?
Boy's been taken to a psychiatrist some time ago. Even if he hadn't been, it wouldn't explain his powers of levitation.
But only you and your fellow believers are allowed to witness these things. Why not let an unbeliever like me into one of these sessions? Oh, I'd love to see levitation.
I've no doubt you would, Mrs. Greenway. The boy's privacy precludes that. The last thing we need around here is unbelievers.
Excuse me, Father. I wonder if you could tell me what you think is going on.
Going on? The Divine Comedy.
You know, they say witches are buried here.
Well, let's hope they stay buried.
Why wouldn't they?
Ask Brian.
Poor kid. We gotta take him fishing with us next time we go.
I don't know when that'll be once I take this job.
Oh, you made up your mind to take it.
Kenny, gotta get out of that house. And here's a job with a free apartment attached. How can I say no to this?
I could find us an apartment.
Ken, you've been looking for 3 months. Places you wouldn't live in and prices you can't afford.
Oh, I just don't want you to take a job that you really don't like.
I like it. It's a kennel. I love dogs. Nobody trims poodles better than I do.
And where are we going exactly?
Townhouse restaurant.
Oh, yeah, nice place. What's his face has good taste.
His name's Philip Russo. His face is kind and gentle. You like him, Kenneth.
Yeah. If you like him, I like him. As long as you don't like him too much.
I like you too much.
Oh, you wouldn't go so far as to say it's love.
No, not before lunch. Okay, it's love.
Look! You'd like Australia, Nancy. You'd fit right in.
Oh, really? Why do you say that?
I don't know. You just seem like a girl who likes a good time.
You got that right, Phil.
I like a good time, but I don't have to go to Australia to find it.
Of course not.
Aren't you American?
Well, yes, but I've traveled around the world a lot, mostly in Australia.
I'd love to go there.
You'd love to go anywhere.
Traveling is the only way to go.
So, about this job.
Oh, yes, the job.
When does it start?
Right away. I've reopened the kennel. The phone started to ring. It could begin tomorrow.
And it still comes with an apartment included.
Of course. It's going to take some time to get it ready, though. It's been vacant so long. I could, have you in it 2 weeks?
Great. And, you don't mind if Kenny lives there with me?
Kenny. But of course not. Kenny would be more than welcome.
Thanks.
So, you accept, Nancy?
I accept.
Well, I can't tell you how relieved I am. Because to tell you the truth, I don't know a thing about trimming dogs.
Brian, for God's sake!
Dead man. Dead man.
Don't you call me a dead man. You're the one that's dead. And if you ain't, I'll kill you. You come out of Brian. I'll take you on. I'll take you on. You hear me?
Kenny! No! They told you not to say that.
I don't care. I've had enough.
You stink. Your yellow guts stink.
No, you're the one who stinks. You're the one who stinks, man. You come out of Brian so I can fight you. You coming to me, I'll show you who stinks.
You die tomorrow. You die tomorrow at work.
Schnauzer, it's important to trim the muzzle blunt. See? Square edges.
You're marvelous, you know. What would I do without you?
Oh, I don't know. I guess you'd be up to your hips in shaggy dogs. Ken, what are you doing here?
Hey, sport. Good to see you.
Yeah, good to see you, Phil. Good to see anything.
What happened?
Well, you remember what Brian said last night about me getting killed at work?
Yeah.
Yeah, well, today I damn near did.
How? Fell from a tree, maybe 50 feet.
Oh, my God. Beast.
Brian's beast. Just as sure as I'm standing here.
Give me a break, sport. You can't believe that.
Listen, Phil, if you don't want to believe it, forget it. You know, you're probably better off anyway.
Well, sport, most people don't believe it. And I say they are better off. Just as I've never believed in the Wicked Witch of the West. And she's never bothered me a day in my life.
You know what I think, Ken? Last night you were wrestling with a beast. You challenged it to take you on. So today it did.
Oh, Lord.
You called?
Guy. The more I read these notes I've taken on the Fraser case, the more certain I become.
Of what?
It's going to be a tragedy in that house, or proceeding from that house, some act of violence, I don't know.
Can you be more specific?
No, not yet, but it's strong, Guy, there's no doubt.
Then you better make the call.
I will.
police, Officer Byers.
Officer Byers, this is Charlotte Harris.
Charlotte? Oh, yes, Mrs. Harris. What can I do for you?
Well, I'm not quite sure. Perhaps if you'll
just listen.
That's why I'm here.
I simply want to say
that I have the strongest premonition that there's going to be some terrible act of violence at the Fraser house, or by someone living in that house. I don't know what it will be or when, but it will happen, I assure you. It's going to be a tragedy in that house. Some act of violence. I don't know. I don't know, officer. Maybe just keep a closer watch. I don't know. Oh, hold on a moment, please. There's someone at the door. I ever saw a bashful devil.
Thank you! Thank you!
Officer Byers.
Mrs. Harris, may I ask you a question?
Certainly.
Do you really believe the Fraser boy is possessed by the devil?
By demons, Officer Byers.
By demons straight up out of hell.
You really, truly believe that?
With all my heart. And if you doubt it, you doubt it at your peril. Good night, officer.
Mrs. Harris. Mrs. Harris. Happy Halloween.
What's for dinner?
I don't know. Mom didn't say.
You think tomorrow night we'll be having dinner in our old apartment?
Yeah, Philip doesn't change his mind.
No, he's not going to change his mind. He likes you too much.
Where'd you get that?
Come on. I bet he can barely keep his hands off you.
Don't start with Philip.
I'm not starting with Philip. I just hope he doesn't start with you, that's all.
Forget it. All we got in common is dogs.
Well, hey, don't get mad at me. You know how much I love you. I get a little jealous now and then. It's just...
Kenny, what is it?
It's him. Bert, man. Up there, looking at us. Feet like a goat. Feet.
Kenny, let's go.
What?
Kenny! Kenny, come on!
Okay, we're out of here.
I'm okay.
you do that for?
What? I didn't. What's wrong? You look scared.
Scared?
You two were here for about 45 minutes.
Well, Philip was fixing the disposal. It takes time.
And, you were helping him? I mean, you had to be here with him?
Kenny, the door was open the whole time. To tell you the truth, I know a lot more about disposals than he does. If I hadn't helped him, it never would have gotten fixed.
I could have fixed it. You didn't ask me.
It didn't break until this morning after you left. So I mentioned it to Philip. Said he would help me with it, so what was I supposed to do? Say no?
From now on.
Come on.
I don't want you up here with him.
Kenny, he's the landlord.
I don't want him here with you.
I don't think you have a right. All right, Kenny, it won't happen again. You know what I think?
What?
I think you've been working too hard. You deserve a day off. I think we both deserve a day off. Why don't you call in sick tomorrow? Go to Providence, pick up your sisters, and bring them back for a visit.
That sounds good. I guess I have been dragging my tail.
I'll work in the morning and go out to lunch.
Okay. Okay. Just to show you how grown up I am, you can ask Philip to join.
I love you.
Proof.
See, in New South Wales.
What?
In New South Wales. Nancy, dear, I know you introduced these lovely ladies to me before, but I've forgotten their names. It's stupid of me.
Okay, this is Tricia Miller and Karen Miller, Kenny's sisters, and this is Anne Marie Quinn, Kenny's cousin.
Cousin. Now that I remember. Okay. New South Wales is like Rhode Island. It's a state, but in Australia. And we got a place there called Coober Pedy. It gets so hot there that people have to live underground.
In caves?
Almost. Actually, in the mines. In the bloody opal mines.
What's opal?
Is it really bloody?
Yeah, who's bleeding?
The bleeding miners. That's who's bleeding.
You girls drink out the time you're going.
No, wait a minute. No. You can't go. We're just getting started.
Kids have to get back, Philip.
No. Wait. We're going to have another jug here, and we're going to have some more food, huh? Our waitress.
You do what you like, but it's not right to keep the girls here this late.
I'm still hungry.
Oh, you see, she's still hungry.
We're going. That's that.
You're a handsome woman.
Thank you.
I'm leaving, too.
No, wait. What? Right. I got the idea. Pizza. We'll have pizza on the way home, right?
You girls can have anything you want. Nancy, you do the honors.
Pepperoni and extra cheese. And
mushrooms.
Mushrooms.
Never mind. We'll keep them separate. Come on, girls.
And I'll tell you what we'll do, sport.
What's that?
We'll go back to my place. We'll fix the stereo. I'll show you some photographs of the bloody Overmines at Cooper Pedy. And we'll play some real Australian music.
Sounds great.
See you later.
Bye.
I tell you, sport, you best marry that girl before somebody else does.
Don't worry, Philip. I'm gonna marry her.
You're a wonder, sport. So where'd you learn about stereos and stuff like that?
Here and there. Just a busted connection.
Yeah? Story of my life.
Try it now.
Okay. There we go. Waltzing Matilda. Waltzing Matilda. You'll come waltzing Matilda with me. You'll come a waltzing Matilda with me.
Pizza!
Pizza! Pizza! Da da
da da da. Come a waltzing Matilda with me.
Can we turn that down?
Waltzing Matilda, waltzing.
Turn it up? Well, of course we can turn it up.
Down, Phil.
Then
turn it down.
Louder?
Phil, turn it down. Waltzing Matilda, you think you're sit down.
Louder? Waltzing Matilda, waltzing Matilda. Louder? No, wait a minute. What's this? The party's just getting started.
I'm sorry, you've had too much to drink.
Too much? I'm just getting started.
That's what I'm afraid of.
No, wait a minute. Nancy, love, I know how I feel about you.
Phil, behave yourself. Come on, girl, let's go. Anne-Marie,
Now, wait a minute. I'm still the boss around here.
We're not working.
But it's still a working day. Nancy, listen to me. Come back here. I don't want you to leave. Let the others go and you stay.
Come on, Anne-Marie.
No, Anne-Marie's staying here.
Let her go, Phil.
She stays, and you do too.
I can't see what's going on.
It's not like that.
He's acting like your boyfriend.
He's my boss. Assault.
I'll show him his boss.
Kenny, I swear to you. Let's get in the car. Anne-Marie, get out here. Anne-Marie, I want you to get into the car.
No, you're staying with me or I'll hurt you.
Let go of her! You've made Kenny good and mad. I'm warning you, Philip.
You're not walking out on me, can't you hear me? You're singing with me.
You let her go!
Come on, sport. Hey.
Stop it right now!
You want to fight, sport? Huh? Is that what you want?
To grab my sister?
To grab my girl?
No, both of you, stop it right now!
Thank you.
Philip? Are you all right? Philip? Oh, my God.
I'll go get him.
Careful. They're saying he just killed somebody.
Who are you? My name is Andy. I'm a cop. I'm here to help you. Victim. He was stabbed in the chest and he's dead.
I did it. I don't know why I'm here.
You're here because you're under arrest. You're being charged with murder.
No, I didn't hurt that man. I swear to God, I didn't hurt Philip Russo. Are you sure that he's dead?
I'm sure. You know what town you're in?
Newport.
Right. Okay, so I've told you where you are and what you've been charged with. Now I'm required to advise you of your constitutional rights before I talk to you.
I don't know what to say. I wake up here and...
Have you been drinking?
Yes. Very heavily, yes. I don't know.
He was possessed by demons, and we're going to go the limit to try to convince people and the court that this boy did come under possession and was under possession at the time of the stabbing.
But is possession a defense? If it isn't, it should be.
Demonologists.
They say they're going to prove that the devil made Kenny do it.
May not prove it. I'm not so sure they're wrong.
We have a right to bring in the bishop. We have a right to bring in five Roman Catholic priests who were involved in this case for 8 months prior to a murder. We are allowed to bring in another priest who is an expert in exorcism and who was involved in this case. Now, a jury decides whatever weight this evidence is to be given. The jury may decide it has no weight, no merit. But this is a defense and a question up to a jury, not up to a judge to say I don't believe it.
May I interrupt for a moment? That's not what I said.
Certainly you...
I said there was no such defense, period.
But then, Your Honor, is...
You are trying to prove that a demon took possession of his body and destroyed his specific intent. That he did not have the mental capacity to commit the crime.
Mental capacity has nothing to do with it.
No, it does. Mental capacity is exactly what it has to do with.
The court is confusing the mental state...
That the court is confused.
We can bring in 50 or 100 priests who will tell the court that when someone is demonically possessed, he does not have the intent to do a particular act.
You lost me somewhere along the line.
I'm just saying, if the court interjects its own belief or lack of belief in this area, that I think the court should consider disqualifying itself from this particular case and letting another judge sit here who could be more objective in this matter.
Mr. Marino, if I disqualified myself, every time I ruled against an individual, I would be on vacation most of the time. If that's a motion for disqualification, it's denied.
The court has taken this position before any evidence is even presented.
Just a minute. I'm excluding the evidence on the basis that there is no such defense. That one, even if you prove demonic possession, it would not affect intent. Number two, that I will take judicial notice, as I indicated, that in this field, there is not a sufficient degree of reliability to even present the evidence to a jury. And number three, that you fail to comply with the practice book provisions as far as notifying the prosecuting authority that you intended to introduce expert testimony, that the accused did not have the mental state required to commit the crime. Now, do you want to take a short recess?
Yes, Your Honor, please.
You know, it's no longer an issue of demonic possession. Now it may be just your everyday, ordinary, jealous lover's murder trial.
Well, you don't have to sound so cynical about it.
Score one for rationality.
Strike a giant story.
You scratch it, Richard. I get to go write it. What's still left of it.
This is docket number 78741-4444. The State of Rhode Island versus Kenneth Miller. Madam Foreman, have you agreed upon a verdict?
We have. Not guilty of murder.
And of the lesser included offense of manslaughter in the first degree.
Guilty.
The verdict may be accepted in my court.
All rise.
Fraser, right this way. Miss Fraser, could I see you, please? Could I ask, is Kenny still possessed? Is Kenny Miller still possessed?
Am I on television?
Yes. I wonder if you could tell our audience why Kenny said, put the devil in me. Why would he chance that?
He couldn't stand to see the boy suffer any longer.
Nancy, hi. Joan Greenway, Newport Dispatch. Hi, Nancy. Did he really believe in this at the time? That the devil would be in him?
It happened a few weeks after that.
And what did you do then to get rid of the devil in Kenny?
Well, we haven't done anything for Kenny as of yet, but he still definitely needs a full exorcism.
And what does he say to you now?
Well, he doesn't know. He says, I'm sorry this happened. He says, if I had any idea. He doesn't remember anything that happened. He goes, now I know what the boy meant when we had to tell him what happened to him. He says, really, did I really do that? And we had to tell him. And now Kenny knows. He only knows if we tell him what happened.
to the courthouse today?
In a little while.
The bee says he's gonna dim the light.
Dim the light? When?
Today.
Everyone I have talked to in the last 9 or 10 months about Kenny Miller have all had the same opinion, that Miller is a very peaceful, docile individual who, once he is released, will be a very productive member of society.
Thank you, Mr. Marino. Mr. Miller, would you like to say something, sir?
I'm sorry.
All right. As I indicated, Mr. Marino, I do not assume a position as a god, but I have a responsibility under the law. It is certainly not one that I relish, but Mr. Miller, you took a human life. As far as the court is concerned, it was completely unjustified. And even at this late stage, it appears that there is no acknowledgement of guilt, that your main concern is for yourself. There is very little remorse. I quite frankly don't see where I would be accepting my responsibility if I imposed anything less than the maximum sentence in this situation. Even at that, Mr. Miller, you will be eligible for parole in the not-too-distant future. Mr. Russo won't. Mr. Miller, I think the maximum sentence is justified, and I sentence you. Do you want to stand, please? You are sentenced to the custody of the Commissioner of Correction for a term of not less than 10, nor more than 20 years. That's all.
That snake! It wouldn't let the snake in your courtroom! You railroaded him! That snake!
All right!
Kenny. We'll be with you.
Keep tight, Kenny.